They even have a cute little Lion King set up for your picture when you come in. We're totally doing this.
On today's vlog,
we're here, Animal Kingdom.
Yay!
It's chilly tonight, so you can see we're pretty bundled up.
We have not been here in so long.
Yeah, we haven't been here in forever. So we came after work just to see what we can get on and wander on the park. So when you first come in through the gates, you enter into like a general area where you can go two different ways. Both ways lead onto Discovery Island where the big tree is. Now I will warn you, this park is very, very large.
Lots of walking,
so make sure you stay hydrated. And everything is kind of laid out on different islands. So make sure you plan your fast passes accordingly, because you'll end up running all over the park and you'll end up getting tired and hot. So make sure you plan your fast passes around the area accordingly. And keep an eye out when you're walking along, because they have these enclosures set up, and a lot of times you'll catch some cool animals. I don't really see anything now.
We just have some local.
Just some local duckies. But yeah, all throughout the Animal Kingdom, there's different animal enclosures that you can check out. Discovery Island, which has the Tree of Life, which is totally awesome. They do have a nighttime show with projections on the tree if you stay at night. And then this is kind of the hub of the entire park. So you'll find a lot of gift shops on both sides of the entrance, and as well as a couple of quick service restaurants are in this area. So basically everyone gets fed through here and then dispersed onto different parts of the park.
Today we'll be heading to the right
to
Dinoland USA.
Yeah, so we have our first fast pass today is at Dinosaur, which is one of our favorites. And we never come here, so we're super excited. But yeah, so we're headed over to Dinoland USA first. And like I said earlier, you really need to work your fast passes accordingly, because you will be spending a lot of time walking in this park. So make sure you try to at least stay in certain areas for each part of the day, and so that you're not running back and forth the entire day. A quick service we haven't tried yet is Flame Tree BBQ, and I think that's where we're gonna stop this evening.
After Dinosaur,
so that we're not running all over the park. So yeah, we'll definitely try that out. They have a bunch of barbecue options available, and we'll show you some of that a little bit later. They also have introduced a nighttime show, Rivers of Light. These are the little flower pods that they bring out for the presentation.
I think there's two of those, two shows today.
We have seen the show. We might stay for it tonight. We're not quite sure yet.
I'm pulling to go to Pandora.
It's not one of our favorite shows. Mm-hmm. It wasn't terrible, but they don't have any pyrotechnics because it is
no fireworks
because of all the animals and stuff like that. So it's all light based. It just, we got there really, really early and waited a really long time for something that wasn't that spectacular, but we might stay and check it out. They also have a really cool event going on right now, Donald's Dino Bash. This has been running for quite a while now.
I think it's just their thing.
I think it's maybe a...
Just like how in Germany it's always Oktoberfest.
Yeah.
I think this is one.
Yeah, maybe. But it's cute. They have the characters, Donald and Daisy, and a couple other characters dressed up like dinosaurs. And it's supposed to be themed like a dinosaur bash.
Yeah. This is like a good kid spot, too.
Yeah.
There's lots of kid rides.
When you enter Dinoland, they have two options. You can head that way to head over to Dinosaur, and then there is a quick service restaurant on that side. But if you turn this way, it's kind of like a little mini carnival. They have a playground themed like a boneyard. And then if you keep walking back here, they have some flying dinosaurs, primeval whirl, which we like to call primeval pearl, because it's spinning ride. Yeah, but I mean, it's a good spot back here for the kids. There's a lot of rides. I think they pretty much can ride all of them. Is there a height restriction on the primeval whirl?
I think that's 42.
Okay. Well, I mean, most of it is pretty little kid friendly.
They have, like, carnival games.
And this back here is where they have all the characters stationed, where you can get photo opportunities. Look at Kelly. It dumps you off in a gift shop. So if you're looking for somebody who is a dinosaur enthusiast, the dinosaur ride at Animal Kingdom will certainly have something for them. We just got off Dinosaur.
My favorite ride.
Our favorite ride. It is so much fun. So you'll definitely have to make sure you fast pass that.
Don't get like all like, oh, my poor kids, because it says that it's dark and highly intense. It is intense,
but yeah, it's, but not, they'll get over it.
It's fun. It's a good time.
So we are on our way now to our dinner at Flame Tree BBQ. It is a quick service and it does have mobile ordering. So we've already placed our order on our app.
It also serves alcohol.
Oh, didn't know that. So it also serves alcohol at a quick service. Pretty cool. So we put our order in on the mobile app. So once we get there, we will check in.
I'm going to cheat the system and click prepare my order right now.
Oh, okay. So if you're in proximity of the restaurant, you can click prepare my order. And then as soon as you go in there, you just go to the mobile order line and pick up your food. It's much easier on the quick service lanes than waiting for the main service area. Definitely do mobile deposit. We did a short video. We'll probably have to redo it because it wasn't the greatest.
They actually changed the layout of the app.
And they changed the layout of the app. They updated it. So we will have to do another mobile ordering video to show you guys how easy it is. But it's pretty easy, so you probably could figure it out. So if you're here visiting in the parks, definitely do mobile ordering. I love this song. I totally just went ADD. She's over there dancing. But yeah, definitely do mobile ordering. You see, the mobile ordering has its own line, so Kelly's hopping in line over there. And they'll prepare your food before you even get here, and you just go and grab your tray. It's already paid for on your app. And those are the normal lines, so you would have to normally wait. I did want to give you guys a quick look at the menu. So they do have ribs, chicken, pulled pork, and baked mac and cheese. And then they do have kids options, turkey sandwich, Uncrustables, hot dog. So there's the really good, it looks awesome, and we'll let you know how it is. We had no idea that this Flame Tree BBQ has seating back here on the water. It is so nice. That is Mount Everest right there, a roller coaster. And over there is actually where the seating is for the nighttime Rivers of Light show, if you decide to stay for that. Kelly got the baked mac and cheese with the pulled pork. And I got the ribs and chicken platter with coleslaw and baked beans. It does look really, really good for a quick service. So we're gonna dive in.
Thoughts
on Flame Tree
BBQ. I'm disappointed. I know. I was so excited to try there because everybody's always like, it's so delicious. And
yeah.
Yeah. Maybe if we got here super early in the morning when they first opened.
I don't know, it just felt like everything was under, like, hot plates.
All day.
Yeah, or hot lights, and I don't know. I got the ribs and chicken, and everything just tastes like shoe leather.
Like, the mac and cheese was good, and the pulled pork was good, but it wasn't amazing good.
Yeah. So now we're off to Expedition Everest for Kelly. I don't ride those.
She's a weenie.
So we're going to head over to the continent Asia, and I'll do some wandering around while Kelly rides by.
Bye.
So this is something new that just opened up not too long ago. They started to theme the Great Bird Adventure off of the movie Up. So you'll be able to experience a similar bird show, but it now has the Up characters in it. Oh my god, so cute! They even have the little Buddha statues out here themed like the Up characters. Animal Kingdom never used to be a nighttime park, and they've really got it up and coming. It's probably one of my favorite parks to come to at night because the lights and the theming is just so beautiful. When you come out the one side of Asia, it actually leads right into Africa. And I just love how they can transition so smoothly. Isn't that cool?
Yeah, the theming is amazing.
Yeah, the theming is just really, really cool. What are you doing, Cal? Are you selling one jahi refreshments?
Would you like Coca-Cola?
Hey, Mickey.
Thirst, yes.
We're going to take a pit stop in Zuri's Sweet Shop, see what they have to offer. I don't think we've ever been in here. So right now, the big thing is the Mickey's
Snack
treats.
Stop?
I think there is like a certain name for these though. D something? No, there's a name. I can't think of it. I'll think of it. But all the Mickey snacks they've turned into things for you to buy. Socks, aprons, plates, cups, magnets. They even have these cool little food bag chips. Look at these flamingo cookies.
That elephant's adorable though.
The sweet shop leads into a regular gift shop over here. They have everything Animal Kingdom themed. Such cute stuff. Let's go safari. Kel, you need that shirt. It's so cute.
I thought maybe it would be heavy enough that it could sit on the bathroom window without the cats knocking it.
Oh.
I don't think so.
They're super cute though.
I know it is.
I don't think they would.
The cats break everything.
They have a souvenir in here for everyone, that's for sure.
Plants can be transported by plane anywhere in the continent.
Wow. Usually in Africa, in this courtyard area, they do have like live performers during the day. Yeah, it is late, so I guess they're not
here,
doing anything.
To the right is our absolute favorite restaurant, the breakfast.
Yeah, this is the best.
Really good too.
Tusker House.
Tusker House.
You need to add this to your trip for breakfast. It's a character dine.
Special
but the juice is good.
Six juice from the Ohana video. Here they call it jungle juice.
Yeah, you definitely have to add it. They have a really good selection of breakfast foods, and then you also get to meet Safari Mickey, Safari Minnie,
Donald,
and
Daisy.
No, Daisy's there. Yeah, Daisy's
Daisy.
There. And also, I think Goofy's there. Yeah, Goofy.
I don't think Minnie's there.
Are you sure?
It's only four.
Oh. Well, there's four characters.
Last time we came, we had breakfast reservations, and they were late to seat us, and we got to eat breakfast and lunch. It was wonderful.
But yeah, so Tusker House, we'll add that to your reservation. No problem.
And
no
then,
questions asked.
For the about the time you'll be done, we'll fast pass you to Lion King because it's right over
here. Yeah, and behind there is the Lion King show. Again, they don't run those at night, but that's a really, really, really good show. So we'll definitely have to add that to your trip as well. And the newest addition to Animal Kingdom, of course, which I'm sure you all know,
Pandora.
Is Valley of Moara, which is Pandora. This place is still a giant cluster.
Only until August, 29th?
Yeah.
When Star Wars opens,
I'm hoping this place clears out. But this is the most imaginative place. That's the best word to describe it. I mean, it is so real and so much like the movie. It's crazy. So immersive.
It's still on if it's going to shoot water at us.
Probably.
Okay,
and I apologize because my camera is not that great with picking up light.
Ooh.
But everything in here is glowing. The ground.
My Nike sign.
Nike sign. But it's all done with fluorescent lighting. And it's two totally different experiences from the daytime to the nighttime. So they really have made Animal Kingdom a day park and a night park. Even up in the trees are twinkling. And when we book when you guys book trips through us, we'll make sure to hop online for you guys and make sure we're getting these fast passes with the two rides that are in this area of the park as soon as it becomes available, because they do disappear very, very quickly. So the fast passes are crucial to get for here. Otherwise, you will be waiting quite some time. The floating islands. And directly underneath the floating islands is Flight of Passage, the most popular ride in Animal Kingdom, if not the most popular ride in Disney.
Property.
So
currently it is a 2-hour and 10-minute wait.
Yeah, 2 hours and 10 minutes, and the park closes in 45 minutes. So as you can see, that ride is really, really hard to get onto. So be prepared to wait if you don't get your fast passes in a good amount of time. It up from us here at Animal Kingdom. Just came for a short trip, walk around, have a couple fast passes.
Oh, something spooky.
I don't know what that is, but
walked over here.
Anyway, so yeah, we were just here for a little bit, and
I think that's about it. Yeah.
Not a very exciting
video. I'm
going
to try to find a churro on the way out.
Find a churro. But it's a little breezy, and it's getting late, and my phone's going to die. So that wraps it up here at Animal Kingdom, and we'll see you guys next time.
Bye.
Bye.